there exists cancel culture, like in porn and in comedy. And, you know, sometimes your political beliefs can get you in trouble for your industry. And what are the thoughts? Like, do you know girls who have lost jobs or lost relationships because they've been vocal about their political opinions?
Yeah, I mean, I got canceled I had to shut down my Twitter. And I mean, like, I'm a director. It was because I didn't say anything. And so I was attacked by a performer. And what ended up being so heart-wrenching to me was, like, I'm always on the side of, like, people and human beings and, like, fairness and diversity. And, like, for me to be targeted, I was like, wow. And, like, I don't like being outspoken because I'm a Gen Xer, and I do pride myself on that because, like, I'm from a generation where we don't pat ourselves in the back and, like, grandstand and talk about our good deeds. We just fucking do them.
Yeah, you just work.
So, like, yeah. I mean, like, so, like, I had been donating money, which I never posted because to me.
And you shouldn't have to. You shouldn't have to be like, look how much money I'm doing to anything ever, even like before this year, you know?
Correct. Yeah. I have never been that way. And I donate to many different causes. And one was a specific cause that I was called out for not being more vocal about. And it was so upsetting to me. The girl that did it, I was looking for work because of the pandemic. And she specifically said, never hire her because, you know, she doesn't support us or whatever. And like, okay, I don't know her, so I don't really care. But
I'm assuming this is Black Lives Matter.
It was Black Lives Matter, yeah. And like, I had donated to Black Lives Matter before any of this came out, but I'm not gonna be like,
it's also like none of anybody's business. And also like from all your work and everything you've said on appearances, it's like, you're like, you're pro you know what I mean? Like, so, and you're a woman and you're like, you know, like you're making female friendly porn, you're a feminist, you're like so super, how does it get more inclusive than you? So the fact that people are shitting on you is,
well, you can always be more inclusive. And like, there were times where I wanted to be more inclusive, but you also, and I think people don't understand, like, you're also kind of at the beck and call of like your production company that asks for certain things. But to me, it was like, literally, I was gutted by this. I mean, just I couldn't believe it. And like, to see other performers that knew me, like, because it's the one thing if somebody hates on you and they don't know you, like, this girl didn't know me from anyone, but then like people that did work for me and know better started attacking me. And then I got accused, like, I unfollowed one girl and then she accused me like of supporting cops because I unfollowed her because she was anti-cop. And I'm like, no, you're just so negative. I don't want to be following you.
And what if you did support cops? Like, what does that have to do with your work? You know, that's
to me,
that's really frustrating.
It is. It's sad because I feel like, again, this is again the Gen Xer thing. Like, I grew up in a generation where like Bill Clinton and Newt Gingrich would meet together and talk, and they're like as far on the political spectrum as you can get, and people talked. And now it's like the younger generations like talk at and grandstand and, you know, talk about how much they're doing, but what are they really doing? I don't know. Hopefully they're doing something, I don't know. But like, for me, it's just like, I'm from a different world. And so like, you know, it didn't hurt my work. I had to shut down my Twitter, which was my only access to getting work, but some really wonderful performers reached out privately. You know, a lot of people don't want to come to your defense publicly.
Yep. I've noticed that too. Yeah.
Yeah. Because they don't want to be targeted. And I totally get it. I will never, like, I'm back on Twitter. I took a month off. Many people took a month off in solidarity with me because they couldn't believe that, you know, I was getting attacked. But like, yeah, I mean, I think that the more conservative performers do get a lot of attacks. I don't know if they've lost work because everyone's kind of lost work. But like, you know, Brandy Love is very outspoken as a conservative. But I don't know if she's lost work as a result. Jessa Rhodes has recently come out as being conservative. I don't know if she's lost work either.
Isn't that funny that you have to say they've come out as conservative? Like, this is so comparable to like coming out of the closet in the 50s.
No, it is. Yeah. No, it is. It is for sure. And like, in doing so, what I will say, because I follow both of them on Instagram and I know them both personally, Jessa more so. Jessa was like a daughter to me for many, many years. But I did notice the vehemence against them and how they were kind of being categorized in ways that I felt was unfair to who they were. But I mean, again, I don't scour through people's social media and every goddamn post because like I have things to do.
You have a life.
I have a life. So like if they maybe said something offensive, like I haven't seen it, but like what I have seen, I haven't seen anything that like, okay, you support Trump, that's your business. And I'm fine with that. I mean, I don't, but like, I don't have a problem that you do.
Yeah. And your beliefs should not affect, you know what I mean? Like if you're not bringing them on set and you're a good person and you're on time and you do good work and you work well with everybody and you're a good person, like your beliefs should not matter. And you also should be able to express your beliefs. Like we all have free speech. You should be able to say how you feel and have that not like, you know, come back to bite you in the ass. Cause it's like, you're not going to be like doing a porn and be like, all right, in this next scene, we're going to be talking about Trump. You know what I mean? Like, I can't imagine it comes up.
Yeah.
Too often.
No. And I mean, I think what people do miss, and you know, I understand like there's a lot of hatred towards more conservative people, but like, I think that people, because everyone wants to categorize, assume if you're supporting a political party, you are this checklist of horrible things.
Yeah.
Versus like, you know, my parents are very pro-life, so they tend to lean that way. And like, while I don't agree that that should be your voting, you know, like that's your main source of like why you're voting a one way,
just a single
you're still
issue.
Entitled to do that.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, like it's still a free country. And if that's your number one issue, then yeah, you should be voting for that. I mean, so I don't know. It's just, I wish we could talk. I wish we could talk again, but mm-hmm. I don't know if you can go back from where we're at, where it's like, I can't vocalize any opinion about anything ever. I mean, I didn't vocalize an opinion and got canceled. So it's like, I definitely don't want to say anything.
Yeah. I'll talk about like, yeah, I think cops should be able to do their job. Oh, you love Trump. I'm like, I didn't vote for Trump. Like I didn't.
Yeah,
and,
I know.
And like your support of any one thing, exactly what you said, Jackie, certain types of people will shift you into a category where all these boxes are checked for you. And it's like the identity politics is more important than the individual.
Actual individual. Yes.
And putting you in not only putting you in a box, but sealing it up. So that you can never, it's like, we're all learning hopefully we're all growing as people all the time. New information should constantly be coming in. Your opinions should change over time with
for
more
sure.
information and through, right, more conversations. We all should, but like, that sucks. Well, you're already in that box. Like, you know, you like cops, therefore you're a Trump supporter. Therefore I'll never fuck with you or work with you. And it's like, whoa, it's like by doing that, you're actually putting yourself in a box because you're cutting yourself off of for so many working relationships, friendships. Like I lost friends because they thought I voted for Trump. And it's just like,
and I mean, also, like the thing is like, whatever you voted for and whatever you did, you know, I think people often make the assumption that like, if you vote one way, well, that way, I guess, that you are supporting somebody that has values that are against somebody else. And like a lot of times, you know, like I've not, you know, liked a lot of the choices. I mean, I liked Obama, but like I haven't liked a lot of the choices that we've been presented with. And I think the thing comes down to like, I'm not voting for the person, I'm voting for the issues that I'm more on par with.
Of course.
Because at the end of the day, it's never really just the person. It's like so many other people.
There's so many other people helping them. And
So it's like, I mean, I my parents are great, incredible people. They're also super right wing. And because of the pro-life thing, and I get it, I don't necessarily agree with them, but like, that's what they value. And that's important to them. And so I'm not going to sit there and be like, oh, you're, you know, a horrible person because you're voting on the right. Like, no, you just don't hold the same things that I hold.
True. Yeah, that's definitely a Gen X thing. Like my brother is Gen X. Like me and my sister, we just like sneaked into being millennial. So it's like, I don't feel like a true millennial, but I definitely do notice a difference between like him and my sister and I. It's like, yeah, that quiet, good work ethic, not bragging about what a good person you are, but you're like doing good deeds, working hard, like good parents. Like, I just feel like I don't know. To me, it seems like perhaps the best generation going right now.
I think so. We still are willing to talk to people, but unfortunately nobody's willing to talk. Like, I would love to talk to somebody on both sides of the spectrum, because I'm a libertarian. So, like, I would love.
Me too. Yeah.
That's the best party. I wish that we had, like, somebody representing us in this election. It would be great.
Yeah. There's, I don't know. It's, I think historically people have not taken libertarians seriously, and most people don't care to, like, look into what the libertarian beliefs are. And I think if more people did, they would find themselves aligning more so with that. And it's just like, it's like the two party system is like, it's pretty stifling, but
you know, vote on issues and not a, you know what I mean? A party.
Yeah.
Because that would be great. The place. Like, I'm right and I'm left depending on the issue. So it's
yeah, me too.
I don't like to say, well, I guess this is, like, it's like my parents, like, this is the more important issue to them.
Yeah.
But they have left values. So it's like, you know, it's.
Right. And it's not just like you're voting for the issue. It's like, no, it's like, which team is going to come in, you know?
Yes. Correct. Yeah.